الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear respected brothers and sisters, inshallah ta'ala, tonight we're going to study together some of the explanation of the aspect of the days of ignorance from the tremendous treatise by Al-Imam Al-Mujaddid, the reviver, Shaykh al-Islam, Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullahu ta'ala. The Shaykh, he said, the eighth aspect, what the weak were upon was not the truth, according to them. Al-istidlalu ala butlani shay'i bi annahu lam yattabi'uhu illa al-du'afa, ka qawlihi anu'minu wa attaba'aka al-ardalun, wa qawluhu أهؤلاء من الله عليهم من بيننا فرده الله بقوله أليس الله بأعلم بالشاكرين. They use as evidence for determining the falsehood of a matter the fact that only the weak ones followed it, as is found in Allah saying, they said, means the kuffar and the mushrikeen. They said, shall we follow you when the lowliest of people follow you? Surah Ash-Shura. And he has relating their statement, is it these poor believers whom Allah has favored from amongst us? Surah Al-An'am. So Allah refuted this claim, saying, should not Allah know best those who are grateful? Surah Al-An'am. Sheikh Saleh bin Fawzan Al-Fawzan, hafidhahullahu ta'ala, he said, this aspect is the opposite of the one before it, which was that they would view strength as a sign that one was upon truth. According to this aspect, they would view the fact that someone was weak to determine that he was not upon the truth. If they were upon the truth, they wouldn't have become weak. This is the judging system of the people of days of ignorance, which they would use to determine truth from falsehood. They did not realize that power and weakness lie in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that a person could be upon the truth even though he is weak. And likewise, that a person could be upon falsehood even though he is powerful. This is the people of Nuh said when he called them to Allah, قَالُوا أَنُؤْمِنُ لَكَ وَاتَّبَعَكَ الْأَرْذَلُونَ. This is the response to Prophet Nuh. They said, shall we believe in you when the lowest of the people follow you. This is in Surah Ash-Shura. Meaning the weak ones amongst us. If you were upon the truth, the strong ones would have followed you. And another ayah, وَمَا نَرَاكَ اتَّبَعَكَ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ هُمْ أَرَادِلُنَا بَادِيَ الرَّيِّ. And we don't see anyone following you except for the lowest amongst us who followed you without thinking. Those who have no sense are the only ones who followed you without comprehending or thinking clearly. The same goes for the pagan Arabs during the time of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They would mock the weak ones among the believers, such as Bilal, Salman, Ammar ibn Yasir, as well as his father and mother. And they would ridicule the weak companions, such that they said, we will not sit with you or with those next to you. Allah revealed his saying, وَلَا تَطْرُدِ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاتِ وَالْعَشِيِّ يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَهُ مَا عَلَيْكَ مِنْ حِسَابِهِمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ وَمَا مِنْ حِسَابِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فتطردهم فتكون من الظالمين وكذلك فتنا بعضهم ببعض ليقولوا أهؤلاء من الله عليهم من بيننا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the meaning of which, so he's talking about, I said, and do not turn away from those who call unto their Lord morning and night, seeking his face, i.e. sincerely. You are not accountable for them in anything, that, and they are not accountable for you in anything, that you turn them away. For if you do so, you would then be from amongst the wrongdoers. And similarly, we have tested some of them by way of others, in order that they may say, is it these, i.e. poor, whom Allah has favored from amongst us? Surah Al-An'am. His statement, is it these individuals whom Allah has favored from amongst us, refers to the weak ones amongst the companions. There is no way that they could have preceded us to the truth. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَوْ كَانَ خَيْرًا مَا سَبَقُونَ إِلَيْهِ. They said, had it, means Islam, been something good, they, the poor and weak ones, would not have preceded us in accepting it. Surah Al-Ahqaf. Those who are similar to them in these times are those who describe the scholars as not having understanding and comprehension, and they have limited sight, rigidity, and harshness, so on and so forth. The Shaykh Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah ta'ala did not write these aspects for the sake of history. Rather, he only wrote about them in order to warn the readers so that they could be aware of this aspect, since they are characteristics from the days of ignorance. Aspect number 9. Emulating the wicked scholars and ignorant worshippers. الاقتداء بفسقة العلماء والعباد فآتى بقوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن كثيرا من الأحبار والرهبان ليأكلون أموال الناس بالباطل ويصدون عن سبيل الله وبقوله لا تغلوا في دينكم غير الحق ولا تتبعوا أهواء قوم قد ضلوا من قبل وأضلوا كثيرا وضلوا عن سواء السبيل. They followed and took their example from their evil and wicked scholars and worshippers. So Allah revealed his saying, O you who believe, verily there are many of the Jewish rabbis and the Christian monks that take the wealth of mankind unjustly and hinder them, mankind, from the way of Allah, Surah At-Tawbah. And he's saying, do not go to extremes in your religion by believing in something other than the truth, and do not follow the vain desires of people that went astray from times of the past and who misled many and strayed themselves from the right path, Surah Al-Ma'idah. Sheikh Saleh bin Fuzan al-Fuzan, hafidhahullah ta'ala, he said, from the characteristics of the people of the days of ignorance is that they would use the wicked scholars as proof to justify their actions. What is meant by wicked is someone that leaves from the obedience of Allah through his knowledge and actions. The wicked scholars are those who do not act in accordance with their knowledge, or those who speak lies on behalf of Allah while knowing better. This is such as by their saying, this is lawful and that is unlawful, even though they know they are lying, wal'iyadu billah. And there are many of them today, they claim that there is no clear-cut evidence that alcohol is haram, wal'iyadu billah. They say all these things. Some of them, they give fatawa, a wrong fatawa, that it is permissible to buy a house with mortgage, means with interest basically, because you live in the land of the kuffar, of the disbelievers. I don't know where they bring this from. So it's clear cut that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made the riba haram. But these wicked scholars, they make it halal for the people. And the people, because they follow their desires, they don't go and ask another scholar because they've been fatwa shopping, so they're looking for something like that. When they hear it, they fly with it, and they go and say, oh, alim so-and-so, Yusuf al-Qaradawi said this and that. Do you take your knowledge from Yusuf al-Qaradawi? Or you have to go and seek for a scholar who you know that you trust him in his deen, in his aqidah, in his knowledge, that other scholars have praised, scholars from Ahl-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. But a lot of people, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide them, they don't do their homework. The Shaykh, he said, even though they know they are lying, na'udhu billah min dalik, for the sake of achieving their ambitions and following their desires, hiding behind the fact that they are scholars and that the people trust them. As for the wicked worshippers, they are those who do actions without knowledge, and the people trust them. As they say, these are righteous individuals. And worse than that, you know, a lot of people, when they see someone with a turban and he has a beard and he knows how to talk and the like, they say, oh, he's a scholar, he's a sheikh. Because a lot of these laymen, they're ignorant. They don't know who the sheikh is. So they give him that title of the sheikh and they puff him up. And now, before you know it, he starts issuing fatwas and then he mislead the people. No one should be deluded by a scholar or worshipper unless each of them is firmly established and steadfast upon the religion of Allah. Allah says concerning the Jews and the Christians, يَا أَيُّوَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنَّ كَثِيرًا مِنَ الْأَحْبَارِ وَالرُّهْبَانِ لَيَأْكُلُونَ أَمْوَالَ النَّاسِ بِالْبَاطِلِ وَيَصُدُّونَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. O you who believe, verily, there are many of the rabbis and the monks that take the wealth of mankind unjustly and hinder mankind from the way of Allah. And he also says, اتخذوا أحبارهم ورهبانهم أربابا من دون الله. They took their rabbis and monks as lords beside Allah. Surat At-Tawbah. This was since they permitted the unlawful for them, and they obeyed them in that. And because they prohibited the lawful for them, and they obeyed them in that, so as a result of this, they became lords beside Allah. Na'udhu billah min dalik. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one who legislates. He is the one that legislates. No one else legislates. No one can come to something haram and say, well, it's halal. Na'udhu billah min dalik. For worldly gains, wal'iyadu billah. So he said, as a result of this, they became lords beside Allah, and we seek Allah's refuge from that. This is because declaring something to be lawful or unlawful is the sole right of Allah. No one is permitted to declare something lawful or unlawful according to his desires and objectives, and in order to please and appease the people. There are some people today that use schemes and tactics against the legislation of Islam, allowing the forbidden for the sake of pleasing the people. According to their perception, they use tricks, abuse the allowance, and lie upon Allah by claiming that Allah made this lawful and that He made that unlawful in order to benefit such and such people. Na'udhu billah min dalik. These are the ones that sold their hereafter for a despicable price of this world. Wal'iyadu billah. These are the wicked scholars. The word fasiq, wicked, means one who departs from the obedience of Allah. Allah says, O you who believe, verily, there are many of the rabbis. This is a call for the believers to be aware of the word ahbar, means scholars. For the most part, this word is applied to scholars among the Jews. The word ruhban, monks, refers to worshippers. And this term is predominantly applied to Christian worshippers. So, monasticism applied to Christianity, while knowledge applied to Judaism. However, the Jews incurred Allah's wrath, while the Christians were astray. Allah ordered us to stay, to say the following in every rak'ah of the prayer. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. سبحان الله. In every rak'ah we say this. Guide us to the straight path, the path of those whom you have bestowed your blessing on, not of those who have earned your anger or of those who went astray. Na'udhu billah min dalik. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from those two paths. Those whom Allah blessed are the ones who possess knowledge and actions. Those who have earned your anger refers to those who have knowledge yet do not act on it. And they are the wicked scholars. Na'udhu billah min dalik. Those who went astray refers to the monks among the Christian and others who worship Allah without proofs and not based on any firm knowledge. Rather, they only worship Allah through innovations, newly introduced practices, and superstitions. In this surah, Allah has forbidden us from being like or going near the wicked scholars and the misguided worshippers. And He commanded us to accept the truth, based on its evidences from the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Nowadays, when someone has a desire for something, he said, so and so has issued a ruling permitting this, without looking at where he derived the proof for it from the Book and the Sunnah. And if you say to him, the religious verdict is wrong, he will respond, it's not on me, so long as so-and-so has issued a ruling on it. And if the religious verdict does not conform to his desires, he says, this ruling is not correct, subhanallah, or it's harsh. Then they begin to gather false reports and erroneous stances of some of the scholars and compile them into a book which they present to the people for the sake of expanding their mindset according to their perception. And say to them, the religion of Islam has allowed this. Do not make things constricted for the people. And when it is examination, they say, طيب. And when it is said to them, subject this view to the Quran and the Sunnah for examination, they say, these are the statements of the scholars. Is a scholar greater than the Quran and the Sunnah, such that his word are not to be subjected to the Book and the Sunnah? Only the people of desires do this, and we seek refuge in Allah. There are the ones who took their rabbis and monks as lords beside Allah. Surah At-Tawbah. And when they are forbidden from innovation, which the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned about, they say, so-and-so did this, and is a scholar or a righteous person. Or they say, such-and-such country does this, and they have righteousness and piety. We say righteousness and piety are not sufficient. One must also be in conformity with the Quran and Sunnah. So taking the statement and opinions of the scholars and worshippers wholeheartedly, without referencing that back to the Quran and the Sunnah is the way of the people of the days of ignorance, those who took their rabbis and monks as lords beside Allah. There are so many benefits in this aspect, my dear respected brothers and sisters, that from one of them is the importance of seeking knowledge and the importance of the knowledge taken from Al-Kitab or Sunnah, and also the importance of knowledge to be taken from the right source, from the right scholars, not anyone. You can't just go to anyone and take knowledge from him unless you know this so-called scholar, if he is upon the way of the Salaf or he is an innovator. Make sure that you take knowledge from the scholars of Al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, those who tread and traverse the path of the Salaf, right? And a scholar that other scholars have recommended him. Like the like of Sheikh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, al-Imam ibn al-Qayyim, Sheikh al-Islam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, al-Imam Abd al-Aziz ibn Abdullah ibn Baz, al-Sheikh al-Allama, Salih ibn Fuzan al-Fuzan, al-Sheikh al-Allama al-Muhaddith, Sheikh Nasr al-Din al-Albani, al-Sheikh al-Allama Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen, rahimahum Allah ta'ala, these are the scholars. You take knowledge from them. Because these are the scholars that tread and traverse the path of the Salaf al-Salih, the path of the Prophet ﷺ, the Sahaba, the Tabi'een, and the Tabi'een, the best generation. These are the scholars. You don't just go to the internet and go on YouTube and look for someone, and because he knows how to speak, then he's a scholar. This is very incorrect. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide all of us to stay on this path, the path of the Salaf al-Salih. May Allah bestow upon us knowledge and righteous actions. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon us sincerity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from misguidance. May Allah protect us in this world and the next. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim.